In this video, you will learn how to generate a certificate in Articulate Storyline 360. Once your learner completes a module or a course, you can give the learner an option to download a completion certificate. In this video, we will do three things. Ask the learner to enter their name on the first slide. Display the certificate for the course on the second slide. Display a print button on the certificate for the learner to print and download the certificate. You can use these steps to ask the learner's name at the beginning of the course. And when the course ends, you can display a certificate with the name of the learner on it. The learner can print it if they want to. So, let's get started and learn how you can do it. Here, you can see that a blank Articulate Storyline 360 project is open. Let's insert a text box that asks the learner to enter their name. And then, insert a text entry field. You can use similar fields in your course at the start of the course. Now, let's insert a second slide where we will display the certificate with the name of the learner on it. Let me design a dummy certificate here. Now, as you can see here, all things in the certificate will be the same for all learners, except the name. So, in the learner's name text box, insert the variable where the name of the learner will be stored. From the Insert tab, click Reference. Here, select the text entry variable and click OK. Now, let's test what we have done in the preview. Here, let's enter a name. Click Next. Here you can see the name on the certificate. But there is no print button on the certificate to print it. Let's do it. Insert a text box and type print. Add a trigger to it. In the action option, select Print Slide. In the slide option, select this slide. Click OK. Now, let's test what we have done. This time we have to publish the project before previewing it as the print button does not work in Storyline's inbuilt preview. Enter a name and click Next. Here, you can see a print button on the certificate. Let's click it. Aha! A print window has opened. Your learner can print the slide in PDF or other available formats. But, do you notice any problem here? We also have the print box in the certificate, which we do not want. So, let's go back and hide it. Click the print box. In the States tab, click Edit States. Create a new state. In the drop-down, select Disabled. Now, switch over to the disabled state. Delete the print box from the slide. Click Done. Now, add another trigger to the text box. In the action option, select Change State Of. In the state option, select Disabled. Now, when the learner will click the button, the print window will open, but the button itself should hide. Thus, you should not see a print button on the certificate. Let's publish it and test what we have done. Enter a name and click Next. Click the print button. Oh no! We still have the print button on the certificate. What went wrong? Let's close this print window and check out. Oh! The print button has disappeared from the slide, but it was there on the certificate. Do you know why this happened? This happened because certificate was sent for print before the print button could disappear. We have to reverse it. We have to tell Storyline to hide the print button first and then execute the print command. Let's go back and do it. It is a simple step. In the triggers panel, move the print trigger below the change state trigger. Let's publish it and test what we have done. Enter a name and click Next. Click the print button. And as you can see, the print button is gone. Your learner will just have a certificate to print. Your certificate is done. Congratulations on learning this feature of Storyline. See you in the next video. Thank you for watching.